morning, everyone. This is me. I don't know if you've met my cousin Megan. We are currently in Mesa, Arizona, which is how far from Phoenix?
Like 20 minutes.
20 minutes from Phoenix. We are driving back to Minnesota to move her back up to Minnesota in 2 days. Today, when we're driving 15 hours up to Wichita, Kansas, and then tomorrow, 8 hours? 7 hours?
Nine. It's 24-hour drive.
Fuck my life. So we'll be updating you every hour. We got matching sunglasses. We got a disposable camera. And that's all I can say for the.
It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
It's 6 a.m. and I just woke up, so we'll let you know. Stay tuned. Oh, didn't even think about that. Good morning again. Jesus Christ, the sun is bright. It's hour one. We're driving through the mountains. I'll give you a little. There's Megan. Turn the AC off, riding with the windows down. Hour two. I know you guys were dying to see our matching sunglasses. Pick these up at Walgreens for like $16. Like, can't even see out of these. We stopped in Payson, is that what it was?
Yeah.
For gas and to go pee and for coffee on my part. Hopefully I don't poop my pants. Wish I hadn't said that. Folks, we are on hour number three. Spirits are still high. I closed my eyes for 2 minutes and Megan got sad.
I did. I got quiet.
We're in a new terrain. It's very flat. Meg says that this is basically what New Mexico looks like. I don't know if I'm looking forward to that one, but seen some guys that saw, oh, that's really close to my face. Saw wild horses. That was sick.
No elk yet.
No elk yet. I did do my elk call for Megan though. Watched a lot of those videos on Instagram Reels.
Yeah.
Yep. About hour till we reach the New Mexico border. Stay tuned. All right, lads. We are at hour four. This was a long one. This was a long hour. We're about 3 hours from Albuquerque, which is where we're gonna stop for lunch. We bodied peanut butter sandwiches. I could barely swallow it. It was so thick.
You should have your view.
Of you, thank you. We're going fast. Ooh, that's pretty. Look at the racks. So, wish us luck. Hopefully, we won't have to pee before then.
Yeah.
How do I get this to? Oh, there it is. Okay. Hey guys, hour five. It's now 12:06. Which, if you're doing the math, that won't be correct, but we jumped ahead an hour, which I didn't realize.
So you didn't get it.
I didn't get it. But, okay. Scenery. We're officially in New Mexico. I'm going very slow for no particular reason. We were just in Gallup, New Mexico, and I'm wearing, I don't know if you can see it, a Giddy Up t-shirt, which is hilarious. Megan thinks so. She thinks it's really funny. So we'll check back in for hour six. Next stop is Albuquerque. Besties, it's hour six. That's what we decided, right? Hour six?
Yeah,
hour six. 45 minutes out from Albuquerque. We're gonna grab some lunch. It's so fucking dusty in New Mexico. My nostrils. I gotta sneeze. This is the... There's Megan. You'll notice it looks kind of similar from last time. And that is because New Mexico is just the same. A lot of the places. That didn't make any sense. I wish you could edit these down. Yeah. I'm getting a little hungry, so I'm excited for lunch. We don't know where we're going yet, but I've never been to Albuquerque, home of the Wildcats. Yeah. Hey, folks. Hour seven, stopped for some McDonald's for lunch.
Burger.
Doing well. So, did I take us to one that was apparently closed for renovations? Yes. Did I know they were closed for renovations? No. Did it lead us to a potentially not safe gas station? Yes. But I did get a homemade sucker out of it. And I think that was worth it. It was only like 50 cents. I'm going to eat it. Shout out to Denise. I saw your message. I haven't responded yet because I forgot. But I love you, girly. Thanks for following along. So glad we are being entertaining for you. This is our view.
It's great. Parking lot vibes.
Stay tuned for hour 8. We're going to Wichita. All right, everyone. It's hour 8. Energy's a little low. That could be for a number of factors. The fact that we just ate. The fact that we just ate McDonald's at unnatural speeds. Scenery's been a little dull until right now, actually. This looks kind of nice. We just passed a oversized load that was making us a little nervous. It was...
She's wobbling.
She was wobbling a little bit. This is the... So, that's the situation. I don't think I have anything else this time around. Like I said, energy's a little low, but maybe I'll drink a Red Bull and then we'll see what happens. I just prefaced this by saying that the fact that we're on hour 9 makes me physically ill. But we're on hour 9. I've cracked a Red Bull because we're stopping in like 30 minutes to go pee. And I know I'll have to pee by then because of this Red Bull. You guys don't need these details. Anyway, we're doing crosswords. We were just doing riddles, but there are too many spelling mistakes in the riddles, and I was feeling embarrassed for the creator, so we switched. There was one spelling error in our crossword, though, which is also embarrassing. But here's the scenery. We're driving through New Mexico. Probably more than halfway across. Actually, definitely more than halfway across.
Hopefully
more than halfway across.
I don't know where we are.
So, I think I'm doing a little better than the last hour, I would say.
Yeah, this last hour has gone by faster because we were doing stuff.
Yeah.
The hour before that, we kind of just sat in silence.
Yeah.
Our thoughts.
But the hotel is booked. We're on our way to Wichita. Everything's grand. We're in high spirits for hour 10, but I have never had to pee so bad in my entire life. And we are in the middle of nowhere, Nevada. Nope, we're in New Mexico. I'm sorry. I said New Hampshire earlier. This is the scenery.
Town.
Not a whole... Thank God. These are tears of joy you're seeing. I don't know what to say for the rest of our... Like, we've just been doing crosswords. That's it. All right. We are on hour 11. Not doing too bad, honestly. How are you feeling?
Greatest day of my life.
Because she gets to be with me for 15 hours in the car. Anyway.
Oh, we get to share a hotel room too, baby. Yay.
Yeah. Good for her. let's see. Got to go pee, which was great. In maybe the single sketchiest bathroom I've ever been in. But, people were nice enough. I didn't speak to anyone. They seemed nice, though. We made a dangerous pull-off to take a picture in front of a Texas sign.
It was important,
and it was cute. And that's what matters. Oh, here's the scene. Passed by a couple of ranches. We are in Texas.
Yeah.
Fun. We are currently apparently driving towards wildfire in Kansas. So that's exciting. Hoping that doesn't, do horrible things for us, but. All right, guys, we're home and we're literally just passing the border into Oklahoma. I was heading into a video. Nice. Okay, we're on our...
check 11
12?
12 12
12 12 if we're wrong don't be mad.
No wait, it's gotta be 11 because we're 12 hours with the time difference and we're 2 hours ahead of the time back where we started.
We'll just say 11. Yeah. We've got about 30 minutes left of sunlight, which is kind of a bummer, but we're gonna be all right.
It's golden hour.
This is, you already saw the Oklahoma sign, but I mean it's really just all of the same thing. I can see how tornadoes just rip through this shit. Like, not that they should. It's not very nice, but they do. I feel delirious at this point in time. We'll check back in at hour 12, 13. Who the fuck knows? All right, ladies and gents. We're about 20 minutes late on this one because we had to stop for gas and snacks and to pee. We're on hour 13. We checked and we were right originally with hour 12 last time. We are now on hour 13. We got about 3 hours to go until we get to our hotel. It's 9:22. We're in Kansas though, so we're like in the right state. Things aren't as they were this morning, but things aren't horrible. We got snacks. We're gonna be fine. We're gonna be great. We're gonna be just dandy. We've done like 3 crosswords now.
I'm proud of ourselves. The brain is still functioning even though the rest of us is not.
Yeah, and that's what matters. All right, guys, we're on hour 14, I believe. Yeah. We just made it to Meade, Kansas. It's very dark. It's a little scary, not gonna lie, but the fear helps keep us awake, you know? It's a healthy dose of it. I'm only taking this video because we've hit a town and there's light outside. So in the future, the videos might just be sound only.
The surroundings.
Maybe I'll take a video of the surroundings, like when it's just that pitch black. See really what we're working with. We've been slowly traveling behind a semi and a pickup truck just because they've got bright lights. So we'll be fine. We got 2 hours left.
Yeah,
it'll be great.
Not tired at all.
Not tired at all. Been doing crosswords, eating some pretzels, you know. Alrighty, guys. I'm not going to turn on any lights in here because that's just dangerous, straight up. But we are on hour 15, and oh, you can kind of see the reflection of my glasses. This is our view. We are alone out here completely most of the time, but we're about an hour and a half, give or take, away from our hotel. We'll probably have one more hourly check-in, and then we're just going to bed. Like, that's just the situation. Oh, is that a semi that just pulled in front of us?
What do you mean just pulled in front of us? He's been there, dude.
I thought he just pulled out right there. Anyway, yeah, we'll update you in another hour. All right. We're on hour 16 and the last hour of the road trip. We've got about 45 minutes until we're at our hotel. This will be the last video because simply we're just going to check in and go straight to bed. Thank you all for being a part of this. We've got day 2 tomorrow, but we're not gonna think about that right now. We're thinking about laying in comfy hotel beds and eating breakfast tomorrow morning, and that's it. If I had to say anything, I would say, maybe don't drive 15 hours in one day in the future, but that's up to you, girlies. That's your choice. Anyway, good night. We'll see you all tomorrow for day 2. Good morning, everyone. This is a lot less aggressive greeting than the last one. I'll tell you that much. That one got scrapped. We're at hour 0. Set to be in Minneapolis by 7 is what the map says. But probably be closer to 8 because of stops. We're leaving Wichita. Hotel was lovely. Got in a... This is the view currently.
As if I was.
Whoa, that's a crazy car. All right, anyway. Nothing too crazy yet. We'll update at hour 1. Did I miss anything?
No, that's it.
That's it. It is hour 1 of day 2. We're doing pretty good. That went by pretty quick.
It did. Look forward to being home.
Yeah. Very much looking forward to being home. Not much has occurred. We drove past the wildfires. They got scarier the closer you got to them. That was kind of crazy. We're going to go through Missouri. That's later. We'll probably have one more update before then, I would think. This is the scenery. It's kind of nice and green, which is nice. you know, minus the burning of the crops, but...
This isn't even a pretty area.
We went through pretty areas.
We went through pretty areas. I promise Kansas is not all just rolling hills and tornadoes, but... yeah, that's kind of all I got. Update you in hour two. We are on hour two. We did have to make a pit stop at one of the little... What are those called?
Gas stations.
Well, it's a gas station, but it's one that's like in the middle so that we don't have to pay the tolls.
Yeah.
It was nice. Got to frolic in the grass for a little bit. That was pleasant. Really had to use the bathroom. Got to do that as well. We're driving through Topeka now, which is exciting stuff. Here's the... There's Megan as per usual. If it wasn't Megan, that would be concerning. Lots of green. Everything's green. Seen a lot of cows. That's been very enjoyable. Megan does a cow impression every time we see one, so she's gotten good at it.
It's important.
It's important. She's got to practice. That semi smelled kind of bad. Yeah, that's kind of it, folks. That's all we got. We took some silly disposable camera pictures at the stop, so.
Some man took a photo for us, too.
Hour three. Return of the heart-shaped sunglasses. Very exciting. We are in Missouri. Just passed through Kansas City. We might still be in Kansas City. I have no idea. Spirits are high. Less than 6 hours. Can't wait to be home. It's going to be incredible. Everything's very green. I'm hoping it's kind of, you know, people in Minnesota watching this, don't tell me if it's not green in Minnesota. Let me just be disappointed naturally. I hope everything is as green as it is here. Here's the view. We are officially on 35 North headed towards Des Moines. We'll check back in for hour four.
It is currently hour four. We have stopped to get food and gas. He is currently washing windows. Look at that face. Look at the effort. So yeah, we are, I think, under 5 hours to Minneapolis now. So we're doing good. Spirits are great. It's kind of sunny out, which is nice. And yeah, wow, she's just really going for it. It's good. It's good. But yeah, it's going to be great.
Hour five. We're about 20 minutes away. Say everyone's ahead of this guy. We're about 20 minutes away from the Iowa border. Gonna hit Des Moines in about 100 miles. This is the view. Very nice. That's the pickup you just looked into on accident.
It's really fucking windy out here.
Really windy. Holy shit. Just like everybody's waving around on the road. Not good. Not bad, but not great.
Little swerves.
Yeah, we're excited to be home. We're under 5 hours now, 4 hours and 45 minutes left. Spirits are high. Excited to lay in my own bed. So that's the sitch. Hour six. We are in Iowa. Still don't know if we were in Iowa for the last one. About 20 minutes outside of Des Moines. Still super windy. Got about 3.5 hours left of the trip total. Here's the view. There's Megan. Very excited to be here. We have encountered some incredibly bad drivers today. What do you have to say on the subject, Megan?
I don't really like people.
That we knew already, so... Yeah, not you, dude. You're fine. But, yeah. Just wish everyone could learn how to drive. That'd be great. It's been really bad. But, yeah, we'll check in for hour seven. Ugh, I'm so tired. Hour seven, something very scary just happened.
I was safe though.
We were behind this truck that was pulling, I don't even know what it was.
A bunch of like thick pieces of wood, but they were stacked like taller than a semi has their stuff stacked.
Yeah, and they were like
barely strapped on.
Like leaning precariously. And we were like, we don't want to be behind them anymore.
And we also didn't want to be next to them. So we just fell back. And then a semi was on my booty. And then he tried to cut me off. And it was a whole thing. But yeah.
But basically, so a semi lets us in front of them. And there's another semi behind us. So we get over to the other lane. We speed past this truck. There's a semi behind the truck now. One behind us. The truck is slowing down.
It was waved over the side of the road by another person.
Because they lost a wheel.
So the tire was crooked. And yeah. Then as they went onto the side of the road, it popped off. And then the other semi that was behind us, I was on my booty hill before, he drove over.
So the semi behind the truck went over the tire that the truck lost and then popped one of their tires. And then they both, like, pulled off to the side. And that was only, what, seconds after we passed them?
Yeah, like, literally as they were trying to get over to the side of the road for their tire being, like, wobbly, I was like, we're going. Moving. But yeah, no, it was really nice because the semi-driver, the other one, would, like, kind of saw the situation that was happening and saw that the other semi was being a dick to me and not letting me over and out of the way. I'm like, I didn't want to be behind it. Something bad was going to happen. I was afraid it was going to fly off at me, to be honest. But yeah, he let me over, and so then that guy was like, we were both good, but the people in front of us, like, we came to a dead stop, and then the other semi almost hit me, which was pretty scary. But in general, we survived.
We survived. The view. Try to cut this off at 2 videos, but just wanted you guys to know that
we're alive.
We're alive and scared of driving in Iowa.
Yeah.
Hour 8. We are still in Iowa. Iowa is so flat, like, it's so flat in all farmland. I knew this, Megan knew this, you knew this, and still, I wish there was more, you know? But beggars can't be choosers. Here is scenery. Excuse the shaking, we're just going through some potholes. We got about 2 hours left. Thank God, I'm so ready to be home. How do you feel, Meg? Yeah, we've been doing crosswords for like 7 hours. So, just smarter than all of you, sorry. Hour 9. We are. Shut up. We are delirious. We're an hour out of Minneapolis, thank God. Almost had another semi-accident issue, like...
It was, like, the bottom wind thing was flapping.
It was flapping.
And I hit another semi when I went to pass it. I was that doesn't seem safe.
And it was swerving in and out of the lane. Like, it was a mess. So we scooched past that guy, and now we're way ahead of him. But thank goodness for that. Yeah, we're almost to Minneapolis.
Oh, yeah, we're in Minnesota.
We're in Minnesota, clearly, because we're only an hour until Minneapolis.
I was saying, you never said it.
That's my bad. Just so you know, we're in Minnesota. Forgot to post the view or the scenery. You guys can't be mad. It's golden hour. Look at those clouds. I think it might be raining in Minneapolis. You guys are all liars. It's not green in Minnesota. It's incredibly brown and dull and sad. I almost said take me back to Kansas, but I don't think I want to go back to Kansas. Hour 10, we are in Minneapolis, which is chef's kiss, although it's raining and it's gloomy.
Very.
It's very
not a good end to the journey.
Yeah, it's almost like Minneapolis is not welcoming us back, which is rude and not very nice. View. It's the iconic driving into Minneapolis view. Just minus, you know, all the cranes and construction and shit, which in reality, that's, I suppose, the traditional Minnesota view. So, thank you all for following us on this journey. Thank you all for your well wishes, Mom.
Hi, Andres.
And, I will be posting. I took so many photos on this trip. Like, Megan made fun of me the whole time.
Just wait till the disposable gets developed.
Yeah,
the
we did.
Disposable, not the phone app.
We did get a disposable camera, a physical one. So just stay tuned, really.
skies over this island. Would you be glad to see Manhattan for once? I knew the dream had died. JMZ lied.
Coming this way.
All right, ladies and gents.
Oh, it's like dead. Start that over. I'm sorry.